Hello everyone. Welcome to Thailand Monthly Webinar for November in 2013. For the economic uncertainty in the US and rising domestic political heat in Thailand may give way to more sideways action for Thai stock market in the month of November. Despite the sporadic return of foreign buying, the amount was too small to reflect a serious return to the Thai stock market. To survive the sideways market, we advise investors to adjust short-term trading strategy to focus more on earning and year-end spending play. There will have two speakers today. The first one is Mr. Danai Thurayapichitchai. He has been a capital market analyst for Thai for Phillip Security Thailand since 2002. Currently, he holds the position of Vice President for Equity Research. He spent more than 12 years covering property development and building material sectors. Besides being a MBA graduate from Western Michigan University, he holds an MS in Finance from Golden Gate University. He also earned designation as a Chartered Financial Analyst in 2012. The second speaker is myself, Ms. Thirada Chaning-Yong, has been an equity strategist for Phillip Security Thailand since 2004, employing a top-down investment approach to look for appropriate investment theme at the right time and updating both institutional and individual investor about the outlook for the Thai stock market. So let's start to the outlooks and investment themes for the month of November first, and then we'll go to the stock pick of the month, and we'll ending with the Q&A session as usual. For this November, I think I would say that it would be the month of politics, because the most influence factor for the market right now, especially for the last for these couple weeks, would be the politics, especially in the amnesty bill, things that will turn out that create a more social controversy on the bills. But before we go through the updated of the situation and what will happen next, I would like you all to have a look on the index performance for November over the past 10 years first. From the chart, it is the set index performance in the month of November over the last 10 years. You can see that from the table, the fourth quarters normally is had been the impressive quarter for Thai stock market with a 70% chance of winning, and will get the return around almost 9%. For December, it is the best month of the quarters with 90% probabilities to have the higher returns with the average rate around 5%. What about November? It's not too bad with the probability to winning around 70%. However, on the return side, it's not so much at only 0.2% on average to higher from previous months. So let's find out what will happen for this year. As said earlier, I think the most important factor for the market this month would be the politicals. So this is the key political events throughout the month of November. Start with the early of November, the hottest issue would be the amnesty bills or set to see low bills. For the update of the situation, yesterday our Prime Minister have her statement to call for a carefully considerations from the upper house member for the country benefits. That may signal a stepping back of the government side on pushing the bills among the protesters around Bangkok, especially in the center of Bangkok. There's lot of rally for several group of people to against the bill. However, on the protester side, still have no sign of stopping their activities because they see that those statements from Prime Minister is nothing for sure. So they'll wait for November 11th when the upper house will open the meetings and set the vote. So that would be the important dates for this event on the amnesty bill. So just have to wait for November 11th. And in the same day, we also have another issues in related to the political things. It would be the day that the International Court of Justice will rule out the case about the Pravihan Temple dispute among between Thailand and Cambodia. That would be another factor that may heat up the political atmosphere again. If the verdict not in favor to Thailand, I think that will be add more issue to bring to the government and maybe create more people to join the protester to expel the government. And then in November 18th, another important issue for Thai stock market and also for the economy in the longer term would be the second and third reading of the $2 billion borrowing bill that will impact to the mega infrastructure project in the next 7 years. If they fail to pass the bill, then maybe have the effect to the next year GDP growth also. So that would be the important issue related to the politics things. And in the late of November, we will have the no confidence motion against the government again. That may heat up the political atmosphere again. So we expect to see more volatility in the stock market throughout the months. So then we should see what political impact on the Thai stock market in the past. We plot the graph of the impact in 2006 to 2010. Can divide it into four periods. The first one is in 2006 when the military coup expelled former Premier Thaksin Shinawat. And then in 2008, the yellow shirt had a rally and before ending up with the seizing of the Suvarnabhumi and Don Mueang Airport. And in 2009, the red shirt rally to discharge former Premier Aphisit Wichachiwa. And then the last event is occurred in 2010. Also have the street cashiers budget at last Song Changshan and end up with the Central World arson. So let's see the impact to Thai stock market during the political crisis. You can see from the top row of the table, it shows the maximum drawdown in each month. You can see on average, this will down around 10 to 15%, except in 2008, the maximum drawdown would dive to around 20 to 40%. However, at that year, I think it has other factors influence the market. It was the U.S. financial crisis because in 2008, especially during October, November, that would be the month that Lehman Brothers filing its bankruptcy. So that posed a very, very negative impact to the global equity markets, including Thailand. So that would be the impact from external fund more than the internal one. However, for the political impact to Thai stock market, would be roughly around 10 to 15%. If you can see from the second row of the table, it shows the monthly return that's measured by close to close of each month. It showed a smaller negative impact to the index performance it's actually even turned to positive in some months. It's reflecting that our Thai stock market has been easily absorbing the political news and ready to bounce back quickly if the situation relieves. So for this time, what would happen for Thai stock market when the political come to an to be an significant issue for market? Apply with the same downside rate of around 10 to 15%. We can see from the previous high of around 1480, roughly around 1500. After easing concern over U.S. debt ceiling crisis, Thai stock market has already dropped around 7 to 6%, and the more downside risk to 10 to 15% would be around 1360 to 1280 point. So that would be the lowest level we expecting. You can see that the lowest of 1280 is not making a new low for this year, because the lowest point for this year was around 1260 when the market have the impact from QE tabling concern. So that means for this political crisis, we don't think we'll see the new low for stock market for this year. Why we think that we still have the limited downside and could turn into positive in December? That because we think that the December is the month of celebration. Like we have the King birthday, and we also have the year end celebration. So that means it's hard to call people to do a big rally during the month of December. So I think the political activities maybe stop or prolongs for a short term, depend on how bad of the situation. But I think during December the activity maybe stop, temporary stop. And also we expect to see a slower foreign movement in the late of November and December, as it's always start to have a long vacation. So in contrary, our local institution or retailer would be take a more important low to move the Thai stock market during November to December. And we also expect the buying spree from the long-term equity fund or LTF buyer, which they always to have the pattern, buying pattern. From the statistic in this page, you show that they always buy a lot in December. So December is the most popular month for LTF and also IMF. So that would be have a push from the local institutes on the buying side. So we think when the foreigner lower or lessen taking the low in the market, so the institution will lead to move the market in easily to in the upside, as shown in the statistic that always have a impressive earning for impressive performance of Thai stock market in December. So for this November, we expect to see a high volatility movement of Thai stock market with the limited downside at only 1360 to 1320s, but also the upside would be limited at only 1480 or 1500. So we call to buy the pullback around 1360 or 1320 in order to sell around 1500 once the domestic political anxiety easing or temporary stop. So the investment theme would be focused on the earning play, especially in the first half of the month, and then we'll turn to the year-end spending. And as usual, we'll give you the five stock pick, both from technical basis and fundamental basis. So our pick on the technical side first, we pick PTT as the price failed to sit right at 200 week EMA key support and modified stochastic hit head to a level where a rebound is expected. As previously, the stock is likely to hit the cycle channel and a rebound in warranted. So we expect to see the downside to its lower bound around 305 or 300 baht. For the upside, we expect the price maybe up to its 75 week EMA at around 327 or even a little bit higher to the upper bound around 342 baht. The second pick from technical side is WHA Corporation. It is the developer in property sectors. From the graph, the uptrend remain intact as the modified stochastic briefly reverses course after entering into the extremely oversold level. And the stock bounced back once it fell to near trend line support. The rally appeared to gain steam. From the graph on the uptrend lines, we expect to see the price maybe up to its 61.8% of Fibonacci retracement level of around 42, or even a bit higher to its 100% of Fibonacci retracement level at 46 baht. For the downside, we expect to see around 35.75 to 34.25. And then I will pass you through our other three picks from fundamental side will be presented by Kun Danai.
Okay, let's start. We picked three stocks on the earning theme. The first one is the Big C Supercenter. It's a leading modern trade retailer. Big C is one of the Thailand leading modern trade retailers. At the end of the September 13, Big C has a 118 hypermarkets, 25 Big C markets, 247 mini Big C stores, locating in Bangjak gas station and Duck Store PL 121 location during the 9-month period of the 2013. The net profit is rose just a mere 3.4%. As the third quarters has been decreasing 12.2% in the third quarter of the net profit. Most of the reduction was due to the narrow gross margin as Big C created a marketing campaign to stimulate the sale during the seasonally low demand period. Looking into the top line performance, the sale grew as much as 6.8% year on year and on an increase of the same store sale growth and the opening of the new store, and the rental income rose 11% as the space for the lease added 5.3% to 737,000 square meters. In the fourth quarter ahead, we expect the earnings to improve Q on Q and the year on year, mostly on the holidays and the shopping seasons, as well as the benefit of the branch expansion strategies. In this period, the Big C will open 1 hypermarket, 6 Big C markets, 29 mini Big C stores, and 20 PL dark stores. Out of 3 stores under temporary shutdown, 2 stores at Sri Nakhlin and Khon Kaen are scheduled to reopen in the fourth quarter, and this will help propel sales at least revenues. For the years ahead, in the 2014, the net profit is projected to accelerate 31.4% as the Big C will book the full year's revenue from the prior year's aggressive branch expansion, while the company plans to keep the increasing a number of stores as well. Despite our concern on the economic condition and the rising cost of living, we are optimistic that the Big C will be able to reap the rewards from its multi-platform store expansion, as it allows the company to accommodate a wide range of the customer. More importantly, a focus on the private label products yielding high margin and its cost-cutting management will be the key factor boosting the Big C bottom line growth. Looking into the bottom line growth, Big C net profit will go just a mere 2.4% to 6.1 billion in 2013, and the profit in 2014 will jump by the 32.4% to 8 billion due to the exceptionally low base of the year earlier. Based on the DCF valuation, we see the Big C value is at the 228 baht per share. This is based on the cost of equity 10.6% and the growth sustainable growth 3%. Currently, the stock has been quite undervalued after the price has been plunged drastically by 24% from 250 to 190s. On top of this, this steady demand of the staples makes the modern trade retailer Big C an attractive one in the midst of the sluggish economies. Okay, move to the next one is the CK Chaw Kan Chang. Chaw Kan Chang is one of the leading contractors in the country. Actually, at a moment, they have a pretty good past track record. They are the company to build the MRT Blue Line, which is on the operation right now, and also build a many expressway around the Bangkok area. At a moment, they have a highest backlog to sell among its peers. Its peer or competitors is Stacon and ITD. Right now, they have the works on hand or the backlog is about the 120 billion baht, or about 6 times revenue in the financial year 2013, and 4 times of the revenue target for this year. So it's meaning it's more work to construct and book as revenue ahead. So I would say the prospect of the revenue growth is quite rosy. And also looking ahead, CK is already signed a new project worth 25 billion for this year, for the year to date. And there are two works in the pipeline, namely is a hydroelectric dam project in the Nam Bak in Laos, worth about 17 billion, and 4 billion from the SPP, or the small producer electricity project, about 4 billion. Altogether, So they have 21, about 21 billion waiting to be signed in early 2014. Looking ahead, we see more work to come in next year. But first, we are looking for the public project. We understand the $2 trillion bill is under the process to get approval from the parliament, but the parliament will consider the issue late this month, and the project inside the $2 trillion bill is mostly the high-speed train, the subway, sky train, dual track rail, highway expansion, expressway, motorway, port. And the $2 trillion bill is just the way to fund the projects, give the more flexible funding cost of the projects. If the parliament give the green light on the bill, the government will have more flexible to borrow money to fund the project. On the other hand, if the bill don't get approval, what they do is they would go back to normal budget to do like 200,000 billion baht per year to fund the project. But what the impact is mean is if you can get past the $2 trillion bill, you have more project to come out for bidding. If you are not, you have less project for bidding. But it's I would expect some of the subway SkyTrain project to come out next year, mostly in the dark green lines, worth about 58 billion, and the orange line is 58 billion to come out for bidding at least next year. But for the CK has alternative sources of work. They've been presented in the Lao for quite some time. They already finished the electrical dam project in Lao. One is called the Nam Ngum project, and now they are building on the Sayapuri project, the big one in Lao. The project cost is about 95 billion baht. So they are quite familiar to the Lao the electrical project in Lao. So I think in Lao they have so many opportunities to build on the electrical project like this. So I think Lao will have more opportunities to add more works from the Lao country. So they are not rely on the public projects. This is one good thing for the CK. And based on the backlog we have on hand and some of the prospect of the new work to be signed, we are expecting the growth rate of the revenue of 64% this year and 15% next year. And we are looking at a very good quarter in the third quarters. In the third quarter's earnings, we are looking for the pre-extra earnings to grow 380% year on year and 62% Q on Q on the back of strong growth momentum in the construction revenue, mostly from the huge backlog on hand. It's also, we also assume the CK will book again on the mark to market revaluation on its investment in the CK Power after listing on the market. On the net profit basis, we expect the CK to report third quarter net profit 656 million, up sharply from the 82 million in the same period of the year ago, but down from the second quarter, reflecting the huge exceptional items in the second quarter, which is the gain from sale of the BMCL in the second quarters. In addition to that, the CK also have investment in utility companies such as TTW, the water company, BECL, the Express Toll Road Company, and CKP, the Electric City Company, and BMCL is the subway company. All of these, they will have some income from the utility companies to diversify the risk on the construction business. From the CK, we think the share price has more earning theme to play. And right now, they are trading under the fair value. Our fair value is 25.8%. It's based on the sum of breakup value. So we value some of their business, like construction business and the value of their investment and sum it together to get the 25.8 as a fair value. The next one. The next one is RS. It's the media. The media company, mostly their business has two segments. The first one is the entertainment segment. They are entertainment content. They're doing the music, digital, showbiz, movie, sport, entertainment business. The second segment they're doing on the media side, mostly on the TV, satellite TV, radios. And we expect the RS to post pretty good quarters in the third quarters. The net profit 126 million, up 65.8% year on year. The media business is expected to be a key driver of the growth in the third quarters, while the Spanish league La Liga satellite TV channels would exert the less drag on the bottom line. And in the third quarters, the revenue is expected to grow 20% year on year to 960 million baht. So third quarter is quite good ahead. In the media business, is expected to remain the brightest spot for the RS as number one. The satellite TV business would continue to enjoy the strong growth thanks to the advertising rate hikes and the changes in sales strategy. The second one, the radio business would continue to perform well on the gradual improvement at the name of the station, like Cool Celsius radio station, Cool Fahrenheit and Sabai D radios. Then the third one is Spanish League La Liga satellite TV channel would see strong revenue growth after the start of the second season in August 2013 through the sale of the set top boxes and subscription service. In the fourth quarter ahead, the earning is forecast to be better than the third quarters. We expect the fourth quarter to be the best quarter of the years, and the media business would continue to be a key driver growth at the fourth quarter is traditionally the high season of the business. The new satellite TV channel, Shop 77, will be launched, whose Celsius radio station is likely to break even, and the revenue contribution from the La Liga is likely to be the highest of the years. This would cause it to reach the break even. In overview, looking ahead into the 2014 is also the very best year for the RS, as revenue for the Spanish League La Liga satellite TV channel will reach its peaks in 2014 under the 3 years contract that end in mid-2015. We forecast the RS to return to profitability in 2014 from a very small loss in 2013. RS won a broadcasting license for the 2014 in World Cup in Brazil. This also will generate income for them. And we are looking for the net profit for the next year, the revenue and the net profit 4 billion baht and 563 million respectively. And in our forecast, we already include our expected dilution from the RS warrant number 2. Based on we set the target at the 12 baht a share, and the target is based on the PE to growth of 1x. This is implying the PE multiple of 21x at current price. We call RS share a buy. That would be all from our monthly call. You guys have any question, you can write it down or you can ask. Okay, there's no more question. Is thank you for your attention and see you next month. Thank you.